Hi everyone, today we're going to be walking everyone through a little bit about how to set up the Teseq NSG 4070. You'll see it on your right over here. That's going to be your Teseq NSG 4070 C80 to conduct bulk current injection testing. Today we're going to focus on the calibration setup. That's going to be kind of the starting point. And then we're going to walk through some testing parameters. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and start from the outputs of your Teseq NSG 4070 C80 right here, which is the connected RF system right here. You'll see your amplifier out. This is going to your 6 dB attenuator. Following that, it's going to go around there. I don't know if you can see it. This is going to your bulk current injection probe. All right, so working our way left here, you will see our 50 to 150 adapter followed by our termination load. These 50 to 150 adapters are used for IEC 61000-4-6 during the calibration setup, which we're doing today. However, this isn't always the case with other bulk current injection requirements. All right, so seeing that, we are using the Fisher F120-6A probe. You will see the output on the calibration fixture going to our 150 to 50 ohm adapter. And following that, that cable is going to our channel one, which is going to be our power meter built into the Teseq NSG 4070 here. All right, so we just walked everyone through a little bit about the setup here for the calibration for IEC 61000-4-6. Let's go ahead and turn on the NSG 4070 and walk through a little bit about the interface as well as selecting some of the testing parameters to run the calibration itself. All right, so as I mentioned before, we're going to walk through how to use the system interface right here to go ahead and run that that setup for IEC 61000-4-6 calibration for BCF. All right, so all we've done so far is just made our connections we were talking about previously, and we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna click on immunity mode right here. We'll start with the test setup, test levels. So that's gonna be right up here in the upper right corner. We're looking to start at 3 volts, which is gonna be test level 2. And as soon as you see it and you input it on the keypad, you will see it light up green. That's just acknowledging the input. Stop is gonna be right below that. 3 volts right in there. All right, so we're happy with that. We're hit back. And then we're gonna go ahead and hit coupling devices. So you'll see that right here. CIP, IEC 61000-4-6. You'll see that menu option right there. IEC 61000-4-6. And we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna select current injection probe or CIP. You'll see that right there. We don't have a current monitoring probe on there right now. So we're gonna do no probe. All right, you will see that display up there when it changes. All right. One more thing you want to be aware of is the amplifier right here. It says internal. Right now, we're using the 80 watt amplifier from 150 kilohertz to 230 megahertz, which is built inside the Teseq NSG 4070. However, you can use external amplifiers as well to meet some of the higher requirements of automotive and military specifications. But today, we're just using the one that's built into 230 megahertz. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and we'll look at the sweep right there. You will see it set for 150 kilohertz to 230 megahertz. You can change that by clicking on the sweep right here and changing the start frequency. So if you wanted to change it to, let's say, 200, you can do that. However, today we're going to go ahead and we're going to stick with 150 kilohertz. All right, so that's good to go. All right, and now we're going to go ahead and we're going to hit calibration right here. And we're going to hit system calibration right there. And then when we're ready to go, we hit start, which is gonna be in the upper right-hand corner right there. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna let it run through and we're gonna stop the video real quick and we'll pick it up once the calibration has been completed. All right, here we are. So it just finished. It just popped up a little green menu saying the calibration has successfully been completed. So that just about wraps it up here for today. We hope everyone got a chance to kind of see everything hooked up and how the setup goes and also how to interact with the interface. Change some of those parameters. We rent both the Teseq NSG 4070 conducted RF systems as well as the accessory packages you can use with a variety of other systems as well as external amplifiers and stuff along those lines. So feel free to give us a shout if you're in need of any equipment like that. And thank you for your time.